So today I'm going to give you guys a story time on the worst breakup of my life. Firstly, I'm going to give you guys some background about this relationship. This was actually during college, and I was actually a sorority member, and he was part of the fraternity. Of course, that's how we all meet. So that was the only man that I dated who was actually in a fraternity at the time. I've gone on dates with men from fraternities too, but that was the first like relationship I've ever had with a frat brother. And what happened was we dated for about like 3-4 years-ish, something like that, before we finally called it quits for good. And we had several ups and downs in this relationship too, so it was destined to fail, honestly. But we tried really hard to make it work, and it just wasn't working. And when it got serious, things really crumbled very quickly. So when it crumbled for the last time was actually when we were planning on moving in together, and he was the one who wanted to move in with me. Of course, that's how it works, right? So he was like, oh yeah, like let's try and make this work. And I was kind of hesitant because we were having our ups and downs in our relationship. And I was like, well, maybe we should take some time just to like make sure we're on solid ground in a good place before we do anything. But he was more willing to do it. And he was like, oh yeah, no, I think we're ready to do it now. I said, okay, fine. So I decided to give it a try because he was convincing me, right? And we had looked at some apartments and we even talked about a budget. And we were literally gonna like sign on an apartment, and we broke up the week before I signed anything. So I guess that was like meant to happen, but it was absolutely horrible. And I have to give you more backstory about this. It was a very complicated breakup too. I'm gonna get into it. So that's the backstory about this situation. And a little bit of a sneak peek of the end, and I'm gonna give you more information about the breakup too. So also more information about this relationship. We were like very on and off, but we were together for like several years, and it was kind of tough because it was our first more serious relationship at the time. Like, I think that was genuinely like one of our more serious relationships between both of us, you know what I mean? So it's like a learning experience, and it was not a good one, honestly. There was good feelings though there, but, and we had a lot of mutual friends too, which is also tough. And we had a lot of good memories together, but it just wasn't meant to work out. Things started going down south the week before our breakup, actually. Another thing about this relationship too, I have to say, is that it was very back and forth. Like, I feel like communication was really lacking, especially on his side. Like, I had a really hard time having him communicate with me properly, and I tried really hard to make it work. And what ended up happening was the week before, he was telling me, oh yeah, like, let's move in together, blah, 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 insisting that it's gonna work out, right? That he's serious, that we can make this work. And what ended up happening that same week, he started to pull away from me again. And then one of his friends said that he went to a ice hockey game with someone from his work. And this person was actually a girl, okay? And they were there alone. And his friends had told me that he was up to no good. So I don't know if there was any boundaries crossed further than that, but that made me feel really uncomfortable in the fact that he was like hiding it from me too. So he also blocked me from seeing it on social media. So like I couldn't see that he was like tagged in photos of this. I don't know if it was intentional or not, but like I couldn't even see the photos of him tagged, if that made sense. And his friends told me, and they're like, hey, are you still with because he was there on this day? And I was like, oh, thank God, because I was like, they were so nice. Like, I was actually friends with his roommates because some of them were dating my sisters and we would hang out all the time. So I felt like I became their friends too in this situation. So I'm glad that they were like, hey, like, are you still with, right? Just to make sure I'm okay. And I'm like, yeah. And I found out that he was there, and I'm like, yeah, this is never gonna work out, because one day he is like, oh yeah, and then, and the next day he's sayonara. And I'm like, I can't do that, you know? Like, it's just too back and forth for me. And it's not that there wasn't feelings there, it was just really rocky, and maybe someone else is a better fit for him because it was just not working out. And now that I let go of that relationship, my life has improved so much, but it was not easy. But I'm kind of glad it happened that way, to be honest. I know it sounds weird. I'm kind of glad it happened that way because I don't know if I would have left that situation unless something serious happened, because we both really liked each other a lot and had a lot of history together. We spent a lot of holidays together. You know what I mean? So we put in a lot of effort, and I don't know if I would have left if there wasn't something that serious in the mix. So it was not a fun ending, however it was meant to happen. And now I think he's either engaged or married. I'm not sure. Maybe he could be married now. If not, I know he was engaged. But yeah, I'm glad that it's not me because it was very tough. And maybe someone else is just like a better fit for him, like I said. But, and also too, maybe he's grown a lot since then. And I know I have too. You know what I mean? But now that I think back on that, I don't even think that we would be compatible. Like, if I was dating him right now, I'm so much different than I was back in the day. So I know that I wouldn't have even accepted that. You know what I mean? Like, my standards are so much higher. I have so much self-respect for myself nowadays. That is one thing this relationship taught me, is self-respect and when to leave a relationship. And that is a very strong thing to know. So I am very good at knowing when to walk away from someone. And I'm also very good at, like, addressing things too and fighting for things when necessary. But sometimes I know when it's not worth it. So I think that's a very good thing because I'm very protective of my heart. And maybe I'm too protective of it sometimes and it causes issues because of being hurt. However, I think it's also a good thing too because it can keep you from getting in the wrong relationships. So, and I've had my fair share of relationships that were like, yeah, not the best. But you learn. And then you get into good relationships because I've had a lot of good ones too. So it's experience and you're learning who and what works best for you, what you want. And also, I'm always changing as a person and what I need and want is in my love life. So that's totally fine too. But I think it really set my standards higher when it came to my love. Actually, I know it did. So it was a very good learning experience for me. So I'm actually glad it happened, even though it was a very tough situation. It was meant to happen that way. And we had feelings for each other and it was just not meant to work out. However, now because of the situation, my standards are at an all-time high and I don't have to worry about this relationship anymore. And yeah, we haven't spoken in years. So I'm kind of glad that it ended, to be honest with you. And nothing against this man, it's just like, sometimes things are just meant to end, right? And learn a lesson from. So if you guys want any more stories about my dating life, I've got plenty of them, or any more tips, let me know. So if you guys have any breakup stories, let me know down below. Have a great day. Bye.